Thank you all for being here, and let's give Michelle a warm reception.
Thanks for the welcome to the neighborhood. It feels like welcome home for me. I loved living on Salem Street. It was right near Vova's and by the church, and was at the library. I was taking Italian lessons when I lived here, actually, also about the North End. So it's always, I try to be here as often as I can. So as you heard, my name is Michelle Wu, and I'm running for one of the 4 city council at-large seats. It has been a crazy election year, and I've been in it since December before the craziness started because I knew I wanted to serve. So for me, the reason why I'm running, the reason why I basically do everything in my life, all comes back down to family. As you heard, I live in the South End now, and my husband Connor and I are there with my 2 little sisters. They are 16 and 22, and they've been with us for about 6 years now. We've been raising them. My mom's been going through some mental health issues. She's doing much better now, and she's out in West Roxbury, so we see her every other day or so. But my family, Connor and I, we know what it's like to be raising a young family in the city of Boston, dealing with the school system, dealing with after-school programs, what's going to happen over the summer, what's going to happen after graduation. And then on the other end of the spectrum, still taking care of my mom, making sure she's getting access to the health care that she needs, that her home is safe, her streets are clean. So we've seen the full gamut of it. Something unexpected happened when my mom got sick. And she came down pretty suddenly with mental illness. It was out of the blue, out of nowhere, it really felt like. And my 2 little sisters were pretty young and still at home in Chicago then. So I essentially had to pack up everything in Boston, go back home for a little bit, and start parenting my sisters. And you really see then that family is what keeps people going, it's what keeps people together. And I'm just so proud of my 2 little sisters, how they've grown into these incredible young women, my mom, how strong she still is. But everything that I do kind of goes back to seeing the experiences from their eyes. So while I was in Chicago, I actually opened a restaurant. So I lived the life of a former small business owner as well. Know what it's like to be out in front, helping customers all day, wiping down the tables, and then in the back washing dishes all night. It is still the hardest job that I've ever had.
Jerry does that every night.
He probably has a little more help than I did at my restaurant. It was just a little hole in the wall. We had about 25 seats and just open for community. So any birthday party for kids or book clubs or whatever people wanted to come and play board games, they were welcome to do so. I loved it. At the same time, I got to see city government up close and personal because here I was, just graduated from college, worked in business, made a plan for myself of when I was going to open, when how much money I was going to charge, what I would make, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And once I entered the city permitting process, it all went out the window. So I learned then from the other businesses down the street that city government is really the level of government that shapes how neighborhoods come to be. Is it easy for business owners who have a great idea to make them real? Is it easy for parents who are trying to find a good school for their kids to connect them with that opportunity? So I came back to Boston for law school, sold the shop, and was lucky this time that I brought my whole family with me. I was going to law school, taking care of my sisters, taking care of my mom, and got a part-time job to support us in City Hall. I was lucky to work for Mayor Menino in trying to streamline the restaurant permitting system in Boston. It's very complicated here, but every department is just so eager to help, and there are lots of ways that we can think about using more technology, more information to make that process open to entrepreneurs in every single neighborhood. I also got to work on food trucks in City Hall and learned that right away you can have an impact in launching new types of businesses if you just think carefully about how the rules are set up and how the permits and regulations are made available. After graduation, I went to work, as you heard, for my former law professor, Elizabeth Warren. Got to spend a lot of time in the North End then. So my political education comes from those 2 great figures, Mayor Menino and Elizabeth Warren. And they taught me that you can have the best policy ideas in the world, you can know everything you want to do, but unless you do the politics right, it doesn't matter at all. And doing the politics right, to me, as to them, I think, means being out in the neighborhoods, really talking to people, going to neighborhood meetings, not just having meet and greets, which are great, and you know, being in every single neighborhood, but also meeting people where they are, at NURA and at the neighborhood council and any other, at the feasts. I'll be there. I'll be at Little League games all throughout the summer. So I am just so grateful that you guys are all here tonight. I've been trying to talk about my vision for Boston in every single neighborhood, but the North End feels like the start of it because it was really the first neighborhood that I lived in Boston in, and it represents everything that I want to do. I want to talk about schools and not only think about how to make our schools better overall, but really celebrate the examples of success that we do have in Boston already with schools like the Elliott, and making sure that what Tracy Griffith does there is getting to all of the other schools, because she is hands down the best principal that I have spoken to, that I've worked with. She knows her stuff cold, and she's willing to mentor and train other principals too. So we should really empower her and people like her to keep expanding their good work. I want to talk about small business and how we can make life easier for restaurant owners and other retail shops and other businesses to grow and expand. We need to make sure that it's easy for us to get to the point where we're at that ribbon cutting and celebrating a new business opening. But we also have to be there when the business is struggling or when they're looking to expand into a larger space. We need to make sure we're keeping businesses in Boston. And just the final point I want to talk about is innovation. We hear a lot about that these days, but if you think about Boston, the Innovation District, you hear about all the new jobs that are created there. We need to make sure that innovation is not just limited to the South Boston waterfront, that this new energy, the ideas, the entrepreneurship really gets out into every single neighborhood, that we're empowering new ideas, that we're bringing government out to the people, and we should make it so that you don't have to go to City Hall at all. You should be able to access it from the local library or internet from your home or pick up the phone and have easy answers and hopefully call your city councilor's office as well to get the answers. But as much as we can do to make city government accessible and open and available to people, I think that's how we lift up every single neighborhood in Boston. And Aaron, both been great friends. I'm really lucky that I released a list of 12 endorsements recently from 2 state senators and 10 state representatives. But Aaron was the first one to come out for me back in December, and that it's meant a lot this whole time. Jason, I'll take the implication that the Ward 3 endorsement is coming too. But
we've got some folks in the school. I just switched the Matthews on, so
we're So thank you all for being here. If there's any questions or comments, we'd love to hear what's on people's minds. But just so grateful for your time tonight.